What's happening, ladies and gentlemen? This is Min from Architecture Inspirations. Today, I'm going to show you how to create a wet ground surface in V-Ray 3.6 for SketchUp. Let's get started. To create this effect, we're going to need two materials. One is the ground material, and the other one is the water material. For the ground material, I'm going to use this asphalt material here in the built-in V-Ray library and drag it over here to add it to the model. Now let's create a water material by clicking here to add a generic material and then rename it to water. Let's expand the advanced settings and set the diffuse color to black, the reflection color to white, and the refraction color also to white. Next, create a blend material and we will name this wet ground. I'm going to use this asphalt material as the base, and now let's close this out and create a 25 feet by 25 feet square, and remember to reverse the face so that the front face is pointing upward. Then let's apply this wet ground material to the surface we just created. Now start the interactive render to see how it looks. It seems like the scale is a little too small, so use SketchUp Material Editor and increase the size here. There we go, that's better. Let's move closer to see more details. Now for the coat of the blend material, we are going to set that as the water material we just created. You can see that the water is on top of our asphalt surface. Water is supposed to be quite reflective, but you can't see any reflection here. This is due to the sunlight settings, so I'm going to add a dome light and turn off the sunlight and also increase the intensity of the dome light a little. There you go. But now it looks like a mirror. To fix that, let's add a blend texture. Any texture that goes here will control how the coat is blended to the base material. For example, a checkered texture would result in this image here. Any white area in the blend texture will make the coat visible, while the black areas will mask away the material, making it invisible. Obviously, this is not what we want. What we want is the noise B texture here. For the settings of this texture, first change the type to fractal, and change the low to 0.55 and the high to 0.6 on the levels. You can see that it's starting to look like water spots on the top of the asphalt. But if you look closely, you can see that there are seams at the edges of the texture. To fix this, go down and turn on Use 3D Mapping. This will get rid of those seams, but also make the texture smaller, so you can increase the size here. And I will also increase the iterations here to increase the level of detail. It's looking a little too reflective, so we need to change the color B to more of a gray color. And there we go. What we are going to do next is add a bump map to the water material. So let's go to our water material and scroll down to maps, turn on bump map, and click here to add a texture. We are going to use the noise A texture and again set it to 3D mapping and then set the frequencies to 1 and the amplitude to 0.05. You can even adjust this bump map further with this amount here. Now that looks good, but the edges of the water spots look a little too unrealistic. Let's fix that by adding more textures to the edges. We can do that by adding another bump map. But since the water material already has a bump map, if we want to add another one, this is what we need to do. First, create a bump material and name it to water plus bump. Then let's set our water material as the base, and we're going to add a bump map here. Before we do that, let's go back to our wet ground material and set the coat to the new water plus bump material. Now, if you remember, this blend map is what controls our water spots. Let's right-click it, copy it, and go over to the water plus bump to paste a copy as the bump map. You can see that this added textures around the edges of the water spots. However, the water is protruding upward, and that's not what we want. So go into the bump map and go down here to color manipulation and invert the texture. There we go. Now the water spots look like small ponds of water on our asphalt ground. You can also reduce the amount with this slider here. And there you go. That's how you create a wet ground surface in V-Ray 3.6 for SketchUp. A cool thing about the blend and bump materials is that you can swap out the base and coat for anything you like. Let's say I don't want the asphalt material, but I want the soil material. Then I can just add it to the materials list and set the base to our new material, and bam, there you go. You should definitely experiment more with this blend and bump materials because they are very powerful tools which you can use to create very complex materials like snow or snowy grass and so on. When you create a material you like, you can always save it for later using this button here and later use this button to import it into another model. Well, that's all for today guys. Leave a like if you find this video helpful and comment below if you want me to do more videos on creating materials like this. Stay inspired guys, and I'll see you next time.